During a media address today in Kabale, Dr. Chris Bariomunsi, the Minister for Information, Communication, Technology and National Guidance, insisted that government will not hesitate to fire teachers who will be reported to have disrespected the government's expectations. Bariomunsi says they will be able to deal with teachers who will opt for a court action.
Permanent Secretary was clear that if you are dissatisfied, you can seek court redress. They are free to go to court, but I doubt whether court will give them an enhancement if there is no money to enhance. Even if they reach Supreme Court, can Supreme Court say, please increase the money now? If it's not there, it's not there. So what we call for is the understanding, that they should have that understanding and continue engaging with the government, maybe in the prioritization process as we face the enhancement. Then we can see at what time the other teachers can come in and then the other public servants. So we condemn that fighting if it took place anywhere between teachers of science and teachers of arts. It is not called for, and the teachers of arts should not obstruct teachers of science and the other teachers who are ready and willing to go to class.
He said the teachers who are intimidating others by discouraging them from going to class will also be punished.
We also have information that there are some teachers who are preventing others from going to class. And that is wrong, and it is punishable, because you have no right whatsoever to stop any teacher or any government worker who is ready to do his work. And if you think you want to withdraw your labor, you are free to withdraw it without interfering with the rights of the others. And therefore, we expect on Monday all schools to be open with head teachers present and teachers present. And we are now calling upon the district leaders, particularly the RDCs, to support the chief administrative officers and the town clerks to ensure that we take note of the teachers who are back to class, who are teaching, and by 30th of this month, we shall want the registration that has been done, and we shall consider those who are unwilling to get back to class as having resigned from.
The minister explained that this year's budget had in consideration the increment of salaries for scientists, but the government will increase salaries for other civil servants in the coming years. According to Bariomunsi, next year's budget cannot be tampered because of striking teachers.
That if they refuse to go to class, we shall, like I have said, like the Ministry of Public Service communicated, then we shall deem those who have not taken heed to have resigned. And if there are vacancies, if their position is full vacant, measures will be taken to fill them. I am sure there are many other Ugandans who want jobs or who will accept work on those terms and conditions as we improve those terms in due course. So measures will be taken to have those positions filled so that our children can continue learning. What was the other issue?
While declaring the industrial action last week, the UNATO leadership noted that this was a continuation of their strike that was suspended in 2019 when the government promised to work on their demands they had agreed upon in the collective bargaining agreement that was signed in 2018. Report by Job Namanya for the news.